The objective of this screencast is to develop a mathematical model for a chemical process. For the case that we have here, the information is provided on the screen. We have a cylindrical tank with cross-sectional area A, where a fluid with constant density and constant heat capacity is entering and exiting a tank at the volumetric flow rates of Qi and Q, respectively. As the question notes, there is no temperature change or chemical reaction occurring in the tank. So the question asks is to develop a model for determining the height of the tank. For our case here, we have no temperature change, which means the fact that an energy balance for this problem is unnecessary. So our focus now is going to be on a mass balance. So for the mass balance, we'll start with the general mass balance, which is accumulation equals in minus out plus generation minus reaction. As it notes in the problem statement, there is no generation and no reaction, for there is no chemical reaction occurring, so therefore these terms go away. So an important point to note here is the fact that what we have here is a mass balance. Therefore, we want to be able to determine the amount of material that is coming in, out, and accumulating. But the slight problem we have right now is the fact that we need, for our in and out terms, we need a mass flow rate, but we have a volumetric flow rate. Fortunately, the mass flow rate and the volumetric flow rate can easily be related by the density of the fluid, such that a mass flow rate equals the volumetric flow rate multiplied by rho, the mass density. To do a quick units look on this, we see the fact that the mass flow rate is mass per time. The volumetric flow rate is volume per time. And rho is mass per volume. So therefore, the volumes cancel out, and we have mass per time on both sides of the equation, which is what we want. Revisiting our mass balance, which is now simplified as accumulation equals in minus out, we can now find the in term and the out term. So the in term, our inlet flow rate, is coming in at Qi, and we have to multiply by rho. And what is now coming out is the volumetric flow rate out, Q, multiplied by rho, where our accumulation term is d mass dt. What we now have to find is the mass over where things are accumulating. In this case, the mass that we're looking at is the mass of fluid inside the tank. So what we now need to do is develop a relationship to be able to find what the mass of fluid in the tank is. We know the fact that inside the tank at any given time, there'll be a fluid of volume V. Similar to our volumetric flow rates, we have to multiply this by rho in order to get into mass terms. The question explicitly asks to develop a model that will be able to give us the idea of the height as a function of time, not the volume. But we know the fact that volume is a function of height. So here we are going to further break down the volume term and break it down into the height multiplied by the cross-sectional area, which is how we can find a volume. And the rho term still stays. So therefore, the mass of the fluid in the tank is H times A, or the volume, times rho. Now that we have solved for the mass part in the accumulation equation, we can just substitute that in. And we have D multiplied by H A rho dt equals Qi rho minus Q rho. We can simplify this a bit more by looking at what's inside of our derivative. If we look at our derivative, we have h, which will vary as a function of time, because the height of the tank can change depending on what the flow rates in and out are. However, a, which is the cross-sectional area of the cylindrical tank, and rho, the density of the fluid, are two things that are not going to change the function of time. Therefore, these are both constants. And what that allows us to do is it allows us to remove them from the derivative. Removing them from the derivative leaves us with A rho dH dt equals Qi rho minus Q rho. The rhos are all the same, so therefore they can all cancel out. And that leaves us with our final answer, our final mathematical model to represent the height here, which is A times dH dt equals qi minus q. As a quick unit check, we can take a look at what we have here. A is a cross-sectional area. H is a length per time, since that's where the derivative is. And the right-hand side, both terms are volumetric flow rates, which are volume per time. For area times length is a volume, we are dimensionally consistent, and this model does make dimensional sense.